Welcome back. Great to have you with us. And of course, we've been taking you live, bringing you rolling coverage from the World Economic Forum that's on Africa, that's taking place in Durban. And our reporter, Diabo Seto, is standing by. She has a guest to discuss water and sanitation across Africa. Over to you, Diabo.
Hello, Francis. Yes, indeed. So, do you know that in the past 20 years, water and sanitation in the African continent as alone has been improving drastically? But when you compare us to the developing nations, we still lag a lot behind. Of course, we have issues of infrastructure. We have goals of our own that we have set through the MDGs to halve the amount of people, or the amount of people that have access to clean water, or to increase that that percentage. With me is Minister of Sanitation, Minister Nomvula Mokonyane, and she's going to tell us what her vision is with regards to water and sanitation, infrastructure development, and how exactly we can reach our goals, starting in South Africa and, of course, going all the way in Africa, how we can make sure that each and every one of us have access to sanitation, each and every one of us have access to water. Minister, thank you very much for making time to speak to us. Of course, we have made a lot of progress as Africa, but we are still running behind. Why do you think that the progress is so slow, particularly in the African continent?
Thank you very much. Starting here at home, I think a lot has been done in investing on water and sanitation infrastructure. The challenge has been us being able to make sure that there's reliability of the service as well as improved quality. We are way above 80% now on water availability. The unserved are yet to be served, but there are alternative solutions that are being brought. In Africa as a whole, yes, when the MDGs were evaluated, most of the African countries were almost above 45%. Some could not actually go above 50, save for us in South Africa that we went up to 80%. The issues have been around infrastructure investment and most importantly also the capacity in terms of planning. What has happened is that post the MDGs, the African Union has put together a committee chaired by His Excellency Comrade President Jacob Zuma on behalf of the heads of state at the level of the AU that looks at infrastructure development. And that has compelled all nations under the AU to develop plans looking at energy, looking at food security, looking at water availability as part of Agenda 2063. That on its own is a commitment about leadership, that leaders of today in Africa have found it necessary and obligatory on their side to focus on dealing with these kind of issues.
Speaking about the Agenda 2063 and our drive to make sure that we have adequate infrastructure, how much is your department and government as a whole putting into the South African infrastructure to make sure that we are at least moving towards that goal of 2063 of having infrastructure?
Our estimate overall is that South Africa will need not less than $5 billion to realize that long-term vision up to 2030, and hence our emphasis on private-public partnerships, and hence the creation of the TCTA, which is a Trans-Caledon Transitional Authority, Trans-Caledon Authority, that helps us to go out and mobilize resources for the water sector. It is the one that is driving the work that we are doing on Lesotho, and even mobilizing resources for phase two of Lesotho. It is the one that is now dealing with Umzimvubu, and as well as looking at the Zambezi water resource. And it is all those things that are now demonstrating the capacity of government to mobilize the private sector to come to the party. We have bankable projects not only in South Africa, but projects that we share, such as the phase two of Lesotho Highlands, is now not going to end up here in South Africa, but it would also be shared with our communities in Botswana. And the last thing, it's also about stability in Africa, there has been an improvement in terms of political stability, and that on its own has actually brought in some bit of confidence that is coming from investors. Research and innovative solutions, particularly for sanitation, because that's where you find vulnerable groups, particularly women and the girl child, being on the receiving end, because it's not just about provision of a toilet, it's also for hygiene, it's also for protection of our environment and avoiding degradation of our water streams. So the wastewater treatment space has become one of the topics here over the past 1.5 days that we've been engaging here. And today and the last of the two sessions we're going to be looking at is how we can actually crowd in investment on wastewater treatment, looking at mine water drainage solutions, as well as the reuse of grey water. And given the fact that President Zuma is a member of the 12-member high-level panel of the UN that advises the Secretary General of the UN, that on its own has also made a lot of investors to say there is possibility, because there's some political recognition of the work that South Africa and Africa has been doing.
Minister Mokonyane, I have to leave it here. But thank you very much. I am very, very happy that you talk about particularly the public private-public partnership, the PPP, where it comes to sanitation and infrastructure, and that you are roping in the private sector to help with infrastructure development. And I take it you are having positive feedback from them?
A lot. Next week, we will be launching a desalination plant here in Richards Bay out of the private-public partnership with the Koreans. And in a few days' time, again, we would be having a water indaba in the Western Cape, where we would also be looking at the drought in the Western Cape, but also exposing the private sector on investment opportunities. In June, TCTA would be having an investment session looking at Zambezi and looking at phase two of Lesotho, as well as the Umzimvubu mega project.
Minister, let me leave it here. Thank you very much for your time.
You're most welcome.
Thank you. That was Minister Nomvula Mokonyane. She is our Minister of Water and Sanitation here in South Africa. She was giving us the plans that her department has in terms of working with the private sector to get investment and making sure that we at least have infrastructure to help with the backlog of water and sanitation. I suppose that speaks to the issue of purification. And she also alluded to the issue of the Agenda 2063 of making sure that we have enough infrastructure to carry out the plans that we have, and all the plans that, in fact, these are continental plans, not just the plans that South Africa has. And with that, I'll hand over back to Johannesburg.
Thank you very much, Diabo Seto, and we'll keep dipping into the World Economic Forum on Africa in Durban. Some good news coming out of that forum is the competitiveness survey. Good news for South Africa, moving up the global ranking. And also, if we move to other business news, some good news.